Hi, welcome to Sakshi FIIT NEET Academy. In this video lecture, we are going to discuss about a bond cleavages, that is a types of bond fusion. In our chemistry, we know that all the chemical reactions participate in a chemical change. That means reactants are going to convert into product. While converting reactants into products, based on the reagent and based on the type of reaction, the reactant involves in a rearrangement or elimination or substitution or addition reactions. So while involving in this reaction, there are some bond cleavages and bond formations takes place in the reactant. So we know that in organic chemistry, a type of bond, that is a covalent bond forming a sigma bond or a that is pi bond. Coming to bond cleavages, we have two types of cleavages, that is homolytic cleavage and a heterolytic cleavage. So here we are discussing about what is homolytic cleavage and what is heterolytic cleavage. So let's begin. Types of bond fusion, that is breaking. Fusion means breaking. Here I am writing bond cleavages. We have two types of bond cleavages. It is homolytic cleavage. Homolytic cleavage and a heterolytic cleavage. Here homo. So we will first discuss about a homolytic cleavage, then we will forward towards a heterolytic cleavage. Here homo means same type of fragments. After bond cleavage, we are getting a fragments. Those are same type of fragments become a radicals. Here example, to understand clearly, here I am taking an example, that is H2 molecule. It's very easy. We have a hydrogen to hydrogen covalent bond, that is a sigma bond. After cleavage, based on the conditions, mostly homolytic cleavages are occurred in a photochemical condition. In a photochemical condition, that means under sunlight or artificial light, represented with a H nu or non-polar solvent. If you are using a solvent, the solvent should be non-polar solvent. So based on the type and under these conditions, the bond cleavage become homolytic cleavage. So here photochemical condition, the reaction under sunlight or any artificial light. Here if you are using a solvent, the solvent should be non-polar solvent. Here I'm just representing H nu. So hydrogen to hydrogen bond cleavage become homolytic cleavage. The bond cleavage represented with a half hooked arrow. So after cleavage, we will get a free radicals. We will get free radicals. Free radicals are nothing but the fragment which contain odd number of electrons. Otherwise, the fragment which has an unpaired electron, that is called a free radical. Here it's a simple molecule, homo diatomic molecule, hydrogen to hydrogen sigma bond is there. The cleavage is homolytic cleavage. So how the cleavage is taking place? These sigma bond electrons, which are shared electrons, one electron from this hydrogen, one electron from this hydrogen, these are bond pair electrons. While cleavage, each fragment going away by taking its a shared pair electron, that is shared electron, the electron which is involving in a bonding, from hydrogen one electron, from this hydrogen one electron. So the bond cleaving symmetrically, whatever the shared electron out of bond electrons, that is taking by each fragment. Now this hydrogen taking one electron, it's a shared electron, and this hydrogen taking one electron. Okay, it's a shared electron, getting a free radicals. Here these are single electronic systems. So here we have one electron here, one electron here. Other examples like a carbon to carbon, नाइट्रोजन टू नाइट्रोजन और ऑक्सीजन टू हाइड्रोजन, ऑक्सीजन टू कार्बन, बेस्ड ऑन द रिएक्टेंट, बेस्ड ऑन द कंडीशन एंड यूजिंग रिएजेंट दैट बॉन्ड्स आर इन्वॉल्विंग इन अ होमोलिटिक क्लीवेज और हेट्रोलिटिक क्लीवेज. सो होप यू अंडरस्टैंड क्लियरली वॉट इज होमोलिटिक क्लीवेज. द बॉन्ड क्लीवेज दैट इज शेयर्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स विच आर फ्रॉम द बोथ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, बोथ एलिमेंट्स आर शेयरिंग इक्वली, मीन्स टेकिंग अ वन वन इलेक्ट्रॉन एंड कन्वर्टिंग इन टू फ्री रेडिकल्स, फ्री रेडिकल्स. सो इट्स अ सिमेट्रिकल क्लीवेज. वट एवर द बॉन्ड इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर देर आउट ऑफ टू, वन इज विथ अ वन फ्रैगमेंट, वन इज विथ अ अनदर फ्रैगमेंट, लीड्स टू गेट अ फ्री रेडिकल्स. सो हियर कंडीशंस आर फोटोकेमिकल कंडीशन एंड अ नॉन पोलार सॉल्वेंट. टू अंडरस्टैंड क्लियरली हियर आई एम टेकिंग सम मोर एग्जाम्पल्स. CH4 molecule, this carbon bonded to 4 hydrogen. So here cleaving a bond between carbon to hydrogens, this is a homolytic cleavage. I'll get carbon radical plus hydrogen radical. If the bond cleavage between, so I'm just erasing this part. So here CH4 out of 4 bonds, this carbon to hydrogen bond cleaved homolytically, we are getting a carbon radical and a hydrogen radical. Next, if the bond cleavage between these CH3, CH2, Cl, if it is homolytic cleavage, now we have three types of bonds here, carbon to carbon, carbon to hydrogen and carbon to chlorine. Now we are taking a carbon to chlorine bond cleavage. Simple. Out of 2 electrons, chlorine shared 1 electron, this carbon shared 1 electron. After bond cleavage, you just share the 2 electrons equally. This carbon gets 1 electron, chlorine gets 1 electron. Become, that is, those are CH3, CH2 radical plus Cl radical. We know halogens have 3 lone pairs, 1 unpair. After bond cleavage, this unpair is as it is. Odd numbered systems, both are odd number system, odd number of electrons are odd. If we are taking another example, that is carbon to oxygen bond cleavage. If you are taking a carbon to oxygen homolytic cleavage, then this CH3, CH2, 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 OH. So there is a bond between, the cleavage between this carbon to oxygen, representing with a half hooked arrow. Now we are getting a 2 fragments, 1 2 3 4. Here this is a fragment, carbons, number of carbons in this fragment, CH3 CH2 CH2 CH2, 4 carbons are there, CH3 CH2 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 radical plus OH radical. This is a bond cleavage between carbon to oxygen homolytically. If we are taking another example, that is H2O molecule is there. So what is the geometry actually? It's a bent shape. One lone pair here, one lone pair here. Oxygen has two lone pairs, two bond pairs. These two bond pairs, out of two bond pairs, one is with this hydrogen, one is this with this hydrogen. So if the cleavage between oxygen to hydrogen homolytically, then we are getting H radical plus oxygen. On the oxygen we have one electron, that is radical. So this is the homolytic cleavage. Simple. Whatever the bond involving in a cleavage, so if it is homolytic cleavage, out of two electrons which are bond pair electrons, one electron give to one fragment, one electron with the other fragment, so leads to get a free radicals. So this is the homolytic cleavage. Hope you understand well. Now we'll move towards a hydrolytic cleavage. Hydrolytic cleavage. Here, as it is, I'm taking an example to understand clearly. If it is a CH3, CH2, this bonded to chlorine. Example, this is a molecule. It's a chloroethane. Now we have three types of bonds: carbon to hydrogen, carbon to carbon, carbon to chlorine, carbon to chlorine. I am taking cleavage between carbon to chlorine, carbon to chlorine. So in a previous cleavage, that is homolytic cleavage, whatever the bond electrons are there, those are sharing equally, one electron with this fragment, one electron with this fragment. But here, out of these two electrons, whatever the bond electrons, completely shift towards one side, completely shift towards one side. Commonly on a bond cleavage, that is heterolytically, whatever the bond electrons, means this bond pair electrons, actually shift towards a more electronegative side, more electronegative side. If the bond cleavage between carbon to this chlorine, obviously chlorine has more electronegativity compared to carbon. So if it is a heterolytic cleavage, obviously the bond electrons completely shift towards a more electronegative side, leads to get ions, leads to get ions. Ions means what? The fragment which has a positive or negative. Here carbon to carbon, this carbon to chlorine bond get cleaved heterolytically, leads to get CH3 CH2 plus and another fragment, that is Cl minus. Here carbon shared one electron and this chlorine shared one electron. After cleavage, this carbon shared electron also jumped towards chlorine. So that's what chlorine, this carbon lost one electron, become positive charge. This chlorine gained one electron, gets negative charge. So this is the heterolytic cleavage. Simple, total bond electrons are completely shift towards one side. Commonly, if the bond between different electronegative elements, so bond electrons shifted towards a more electronegative side, more electronegative side. So here what are the conditions? Simple. This heterolytic cleavage occur under thermal condition. Delta, represented with delta. Now here, if the solvent is there, the solvent is a polar solvent. Polar solvent. Thermal condition and a polar solvent, sorry. Polar solvent. So yeah, these are the common conditions. Simple, heterolytic cleavage means the cleavage between the elements that is the bond electrons completely shifted towards a more electronegative side, leads to get ions, that is positive charged ion and a negative charged ion. So here we are getting carbocation and a Cl minus. So in the molecule, whatever the bond cleavage taking, if it is a heterolytic cleavage, simple, give a fragments. Lost a fragment gets a positive charge, gained fragment gets a negative charge. So understand clearly. I am taking some more examples. Here I am just erasing this part. Now here I am taking an example, that is alcohol. So carbon to carbon, carbon to oxygen, oxygen to hydrogen, and carbon to hydrogen. Now I am taking cleavage between oxygen to hydrogen. Obviously oxygen is more electronegative and bond electron shifted towards oxygen, and the representation is arrow, complete arrow. So whatever the electrons are shifting direction, if shifting towards left arrow direction, if it is right side, right direction. So this is direction, means bond electrons are shifting towards this element. So we are getting a fragments CH3 CH2 bonded to oxygen, negative H plus, that is CH3 bonded to CH2 O negative plus H plus, because hydrogen lost one electron. Same molecule, that is alcohol, CH3, CH2, OH. If the bond between carbon to oxygen, the cleavage between carbon to oxygen, then the bond electron shifted towards the oxygen side, because oxygen is more electronegative compared to carbon. Now we are getting a fragment, that is one fragment is CH3, CH2 plus, and another fragment is OH minus, OH minus. Next example, that is H2O molecule. So bent shape, oxygen two lone pairs, two bond pairs, hydrolytic cleavage, oxygen to hydrogen or this oxygen to in between these and in between these elements. So whatever hydrogen oxygen is common. So if it is a bond cleavage between oxygen to hydrogen, whatever here or here, simple, the electrons are shifted towards oxygen, hydrogen loses one electron, leads to get a OH minus, oxygen getting negative charge with hydrogen, and H gets positive charge, OH minus H plus. This is the cleavage in a water molecule, that is heterolytically. Example, I am taking a carboxylic acid, that is CH2C double bond O, OH. The bond cleavage between oxygen to hydrogen, because compared to all the bonds, oxygen to hydrogen bond is weak bond because of resonance occurred around this carbon to oxygen. So when we are taking a thermal energy here, obviously oxygen to hydrogen bond get cleave heterolytically, and here oxygen to hydrogen bond electrons are shifted towards oxygen, leads to get a carboxylate ion, that is CH3CH2C double bond O minus H plus. This is a common bond cleavage in a carboxylic acid. We discuss that is alkyl halides or aryl halides. Here alkyl halide, if it is fluorine, chlorine, bromine or iodine, if the bond between cleavage between carbon to halogen, obviously halogen gets negative charge and carbon gets a positive charge. So this is carbon bonded to halogen. After bond cleavage, this carbon become positive charge plus X minus. Next, H2SO4, sulfuric acid commonly generates two protons, that is 2H plus and SO4 minus 2. What is the bond cleavage? This is the geometry of H2SO4. So the bond between oxygen to hydrogen. Here oxygen to hydrogen, the cleavage heterolytically, oxygen get negative charge, hydrogen get plus charge. Here also see, oxygen to hydrogen bond cleavage heterolytically, oxygen gets negative charge, hydrogen gets plus charge. So simple, SO4 minus 2, one charge, negative charge on this carbon, next on this oxygen, and next on this oxygen, we are getting 2H plus. One is from here, one proton from here. So this is a common bond cleavage in a H2SO4 sulfuric acid. Here we have some hydrogen halides, that is hydrogen bonded to chlorine, heterolytic cleavage H plus Cl minus. If it is HBr heterolytic cleavage, then hydrogen gets a plus and Br gets minus, because these are the more electronegative bond electrons shifted towards a bromine. It is Hi, H plus, I minus. So here, this is the way to identify which type of bond cleavage is occurred in a particular reaction. If the fragments are symmetrical, radical, it's become homolytic cleavage. If the fragments are ions, one is a positive ion, one is a negative ion, the cleavage is heterolytic cleavage. This is the story of bond fission, types of bond fission. So hope you understand well. Subscribe the channel, share, like, comment, and hit the bell icon so that you will get latest video lectures. Thank you.